Okay guys, so we're here for day four of the workout series. So today is our second leg session. Shoulders a little bit sore from yesterday's shoulder workout, but obviously today's all about legs. So first up, we've got front squats. So these are 1.25 front squats with elevated heels. So they're almost like a cyclist squat, which means we have our feet very close together and with heels off the ground. So you can see in the video, I'm stood on a plate. And we're going all the way down, so literally arse to grass. Then we come up a quarter of the way, down again, and all the way up. That's one rep. So we try and make sure we don't bounce in those quarter reps. We're at the bottom of the squat. So as you can see, it's a nice, slow, controlled negative. Even a little pause at the bottom, up a small amount, down again, and on all the way up. So with the front squats, we did 5 sets of 8 reps. So that's front squats done. So now we're moving on to leg press. One leg press today, we did 4 sets of 8 reps. So slightly different to leg press in the first session of the week. Today we were dropping that rep range down, going a little bit heavier. Another variation with this leg press is we've changed our foot positioning to what we did on day one. So in this leg press, we've got a much higher and wider foot placement, which is going to incorporate more hamstrings, glutes, and as well as sort of adductors into that. So aim to go nice and deep with the leg press. Go as low as you can. Don't go so low that your bum is coming out of the chair, because then what you're going to do is you're going to curve your spine and the stress of the exercise is going to go away from the target muscles. So the rest of the workout is going to be supersets, so it's going to get pretty intense now. So we're going to start off with a hack squat, and then we're going to superset that with a bodyweight sissy squat. So nice low and controlled reps, good full range of motion from one exercise straight into the other. These are called sissy squats for a reason. You don't need to wait for these, definitely if you're supersetting them after another exercise. Body weight is fine, it's gonna be plenty. So we're going for 4 sets again on these 2 exercises, and we're going for 10 reps on each. So that's 10 reps on hack squat, and then immediately into 10 reps on the sissy squat. The next superset is a leg extension with a trap bar deficit deadlift. So we're gonna pre-exhaust our quads on a leg extension, and then we're gonna go into the trap bar deadlifts and work those legs even more. So obviously it's a deadlift, but because we're on a deficit, so that means we're higher off the ground. So as you can see, I'm standing on a plate. We're gonna drop our hips lower, which is gonna incorporate more leg drive into the deadlift. So again, this is gonna be 4 sets. On a leg extension, we're aiming for 20 reps, and then straight into 10 reps on the trap bar deadlift. So try and keep the movement on a leg extension at same speed throughout. A nice slow controlled negative is always going to benefit you. Get a real good squeeze throughout, not just at the top. Really think about concentrating on the quads and squeezing them as hard as you can. Nice full range of motion, so as hard as you can get it and as low as you can get it. Final subset of this leg session is another leg curl and a Bulgarian split squat. There's a slight variation in the way I use a lying leg curl. I've extended my back away from the bench, So that helps me keep my torso still and limit any movement. When you see a lot of people use a leg curl, they're sort of throwing their torso around, using their glutes, moving their hips. Whereas you can see, I've got my hips flat to the bench and I'm fully concentrating on just knee flexion, so just using the hamstrings. So Bulgarian split squats are a great exercise. They're pretty tough. I like to do them at the end of a session. You'll feel that depending on how wide your stride is, so how far forward your foot is, you're gonna work different things. So I'm sort of in a medium step there. So I've got quite a lot of quad usage, but you also get quite a lot of glute work when doing that exercise. So it's gonna be four sets on this final superset, but we're gonna be aiming for 8 reps on each this time. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you stay tuned for tomorrow's chest and tricep session. Okay, guys, if you want to hear more or see more of me, make sure you follow me on Instagram, which is Justin_St. Small, on Facebook, which is Justin St. Paul Fitness, and make sure you hit that subscribe button.